Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. One of my more popular Mailchimp videos on YouTube has been how to use the Preferences Center in Mailchimp. However, some people don't see the Preferences Center. Now, there are two reasons that this might happen. The first reason you may not be seeing the Preferences Center is because you have GDPR fields enabled. If you do have GDPR fields enabled, you will not see the Preferences Center. The second reason is a little bit more sort of obscure, and it has to do with the website builder in Mailchimp and whether you're using the old website builder or the new website builder. So I'm going to go through instructions very briefly, because it is quick, very briefly how to solve this problem if you're not seeing the Preferences Center. Now, if your problem is because of having GDPR fields enabled, well, you need to disable GDPR fields or, well, not use the Preferences Center. But I'll go through how to solve this problem if you have a website that's already been built. So let's go across to Mailchimp itself. Now, first off, the Preferences Center is the place where people can choose their preferences. So instead of unsubscribing, for example, you can say to people, instead of unsubscribing from all email marketing, why don't you choose which email marketing you want to get? You know, about this product, this service, whatever, or perhaps how often they want to get email marketing and so on. So instead of losing them off your audience, so when a person unsubscribes in Mailchimp, they unsubscribe from everything, from all your email communication and your audience. You can't send to them again once they click unsubscribe. If they update their preferences, then you'll be able to tell what their preferences are. They haven't unsubscribed from the audience. So we'd expect to see the Preferences Center somewhere down here, somewhere around surveys and inbox as we view our Mailchimp audience. But as you can see, we're not seeing the Preferences Center, so we can't set it up. And again, the Preferences Center is where a person doesn't unsubscribe, but selects what email marketing they want to get. And I have a separate video on how to set up the Preferences Center. So if you don't see the Preferences Center here, check GDPR fields. If your GDPR fields are not enabled, then it's something else. And typically the issue is this, it's the website, a draft website, or even a published website. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go, and you can do this, I'm gonna go into a website. So I'm clicking website to the left of the screen. You can see that I have a website published. Yours may even be in draft. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to go into settings. So I'm clicking the settings button and I'm going to make this draft. So if I go down under site status, I'm going to click edit, then unpublish site, and I'm going to click again unpublish. So we now have a draft or an unpublished site. So let me just go back and click on website yet again, and you can see it's unpublished. What I need to do now is click try the new builder. So I've clicked try the new builder button up to the top of the screen, and we'll just wait a second or two, wait for this to load up. Okay, I'm going to click let's go when this message, or if you get this message, let's click let's go. And I'm not going to go through the wizard, but you can if you want to. What I need to do now is I'm using the new builder. I now need to publish this website and then I'll unpublish it again. Or I can publish it and just leave it published. So I'm going to click on publish. I'm going to accept the terms and publish. So this website's then going live. And in this case, I'm going to make it unpublished again, but you can leave it published if you want to. So I'm going to click settings. I'm going to scroll down and under site status, I'm going to click edit. I'm going to click unpublished site and click the unpublish in the pop-up that appears again. The changes do take a few minutes to, I guess, sync around Mailchimp. So wait a few minutes and then if we now click audience, you will notice that our Preferences Center appears and you can then create your Preferences Center using groups. So the steps we took are the following. We went into our website builder, We unpublished our website, if it is published, otherwise just leave it unpublished. We then clicked the try the new website builder. We published our website and we unpublished again, or we just left it published. And then you'll be able to use the Preferences Center. Please like this video. My name is Gary from organicweb.com.au.